LCC is a standards organization, and you might say, why do you do developer relations in a standards organization? And so I would like to take just a few minutes maybe to explain why we're doing it, and if you're interested, how you might get involved in that work we're trying to push. So first, why? Why does WCC need a developer? And I've been in WCC for quite some time, and I've seen both success and failures. And when we see standards deployed to 4 billion devices, it's a huge success, a huge impact, as I described. But when we spend years discussing a lot of nitty-gritty details about how this or that technology should work, and in the end, it doesn't get used because it doesn't fulfill what was actually needed, or it's too hard to use, too hard to understand, then there were a lot of efforts wasted, a lot of opportunities wasted. And from experience, any of you that has done design or development will know that the best way to avoid mistargeting your work, mistargeting your efforts, is to make sure to work with the people that will be using your work. And in our case, the technologies we develop, all these APIs, these CSS features, and so on, all of these are aimed to be used by developers and designers out there. And so the reason why WCC actively works towards getting developer involved is that we do want to hear from developers, designers about which technologies are missing, about the technologies that we are developing. Are they on target? Are they addressing the right use cases the right way? Are they approachable? Are they too hard? So that's the motivation for WCC. We want to create the right technology so that they have the right impact. And for that, we strongly believe we need to get developers and designers involved. And it's not just WCC trying to get effort from developers. We're also trying to make sure that we accompany how developers make use of these technologies we developed. So the first thing to know, if you're not aware, all of our specification work happens completely in the open, in public. You can follow all the discussions that are behind all the decisions that are appearing in our standards. And all of it happened on GitHub. So if you're a developer, it's likely you've already had experience interacting with GitHub. And in particular, you might be familiar how to submit issues, maybe even familiar with how to submit pull requests, which means that as a developer, you have all the tools that are needed to get directly involved in these discussions. Beyond that aspect, we have also a set of tools that we hope help developers adopt some of our technologies. You may be familiar with the validators work that are freely available to anyone. We have an HTML validator, a CSS validator, RSS feeds or atom feeds validator, an internalization checker. All of these tools are aimed at helping you as developer, as designer, making sure you use the technologies as they were meant to be used and pointing out mistakes that might be helpful to correct before deploying. We also have a very rich program of MOOC courses, online training courses. So if you want to get started with a number of our technologies, we run this program, which gives you a certificate of completion at the end. And beyond that, we're also working with our ecosystem of partners on the platform. So WCC doesn't exist in isolation. We work with many organizations in the industry, including especially browser vendors, to make sure that the technology we build match what they want to ship. And one of the spaces where we do that is in our developer relationship efforts. We work on the MDN documentation portal. If you're a developer, you might be familiar with MDN as the place to check for information on JavaScript, on CSS, and other APIs. And so we participate to the product advisory board of this MDN doc website to make sure there is a full alignment of the needs of the platform with its documentation. So that's what we provide. And why would you, as a developer, as a designer, get involved in these discussions? Well, the first thing is, if you're doing something, if you have a passion for your craft, being able to control what your tools, what your toolkit enable, I think is something you probably care about. And in the end, all these technologies that get developed in WCC, they are meant to be used by you as developer, as designer. And so if you want to make sure that these tools that we are building actually match what you see as needed, we think that's probably the best opportunity to get that done. Doesn't mean that it is easy or quick or fast, but it's important. And if you don't, and if you nobody does, if no developer gets our input, as I said, we are bound to make mistakes. And once we make these mistakes down the line, they will end up as a problem you need to fix, a workaround you need to put together, or an alternative you'll have to build. So getting the right thing done early on is saving you hopefully lots of time down the end. Likewise, if there is something we don't build at all because we don't see the need, we are not exposed to the use case, to the requirement, then that's a product that you won't be able to ship, a solution that you won't be able to provide. Another reason why getting involved is important is that, as you can guess, there are lots of ideas as to what should be possible in a web browser, but there is only so much that can be done. So getting a sense of what community needs, what kind of feature, what kind of momentum is there behind a specific need is one of the key ways the prioritization of work happen. And in particular, if we see lots of passion, lots of involvement, lots of contribution on a topic, it's much more likely we will make progress on it than if it's something where we don't see any feedback or any reaction or any pull. As I alluded to, it can be challenging to get involved in this discussion. It can be time consuming. I won't try to pretend that these are easy discussions to follow or to get involved to. Sometimes they can be pretty challenging. But that makes it a really fantastic learning experiences. I think once you've managed to go above this learning curve that can be steep, most people tend to stick around for quite some time because of all the great information you gather, all the great people you interact with. And whether you put this on your resume or you just enjoy the sheer joy of participating in these efforts, I think that's, for most people in the end, really the final motivation, that is, you know, enjoying the work you do and the impact it can have. So if you were to be convinced to be involved, what is it that you can do to get involved? The first thing is probably tracking what's happening. One of the key things we need from developers is feedback and input on what we're working on and what we should be working on. So of course you can subscribe to the RSS feed of the WCC homepage. As Marie-Claire alluded to earlier, she and I maintain this Twitter feed, WCC Dev, where we try to curate a list of news particularly targeted at developers. You can also follow the WCC Twitter channel for more general updates from WCC. We recently launched a channel on YouTube with all of the videos that get produced through our technical work. So again, a great way to figure out what gets discussed and what topics you might have input on. Everything we do from the technical perspective happen on GitHub. So explore our GitHub repositories, find issues, submit pull requests as you see fit. We have also this very open program called Community Groups, which enable anyone, whether you're involved otherwise in WCC or not, to create a group around a specific topic, to gather a community of interest as a precursor, as an incubation to the real standardization work that might happen down the line. The idea here, again, as I said, the worst thing that we can do in the WCC is waste lots of people's time and energy in doing the wrong thing. So most of the time, before doing any formal standardization work, we will start by doing what we call incubation of a standard, where we play with an idea before going into too much of the formal or nitty-gritty details discussion. And these tend to happen in these community groups, which again, anybody can create, and of course, anybody can join. So the link is on that slide. You can explore the hundreds of groups that exist today and that are exploring these many topics of interest. You're also more than welcome to get your employer join the WCC as a member organization. I didn't go into much detail on this, but the WCC operates through a membership mechanism where you have to be a part of a member organization to contribute to the formal standardization process. And so if you feel like you have something to contribute to this formal standardization process and your employer can benefit from it, that's absolutely something you should consider, help push internally. Me and my colleagues are more than happy to help in any of these discussions. I mentioned the developer tools we make available. They are all open source. And so not only are you invited to use them, but if you want to contribute in improving them, that would be very welcome as well. And finally, we have this huge open source project called Web Platform Test, which helps verify interoperability across browsers of the various technologies we build. And that, again, is completely open source, has a huge impact. I won't go into details because it's also a complex project, but if you're keen on helping advance specific features, it's a very potent tool to that end. Feel free to get in touch. I'm dom@wc.org. Don't call me Dom on Twitter. And as a Twitter feed I mentioned earlier with Marika and I at WCC Dev.